I'm Lauren.
I'm Peyton.
And I'm Gabe.
And this is Bishop Hartley Network. Today, this episode will include house system updates, athletic updates, and we'll shout out a star student and faculty member of the Bishop Hartley community. Now, let's send it over to Bradley and Kendall for top movies and songs.
Hello, Bishop Hartley.
This is Entertainment, where we list the top songs, movies, and technology of the month. Our top song is Seven Rings by Ariana Grande, which is off her new album, Thank You Next. You should really go check it out. I've listened to it personally, and I really enjoyed it. I think Kendall did too.
No, I've never listened to it ever.
He's going to, though, after this.
Our top movie is The Madea Family Funeral. It says here that 87% like the movie, so
it's pretty hot.
I think you guys should go check it out.
Yeah, it's, this might be his last Madea movie.
Yeah,
so it's gonna be pretty big.
All right, so coming out of our top tech, we have the Galaxy Fold. Now it's a normal phone, and then you fold it out, and it's two times as big.
Seamless, also.
No seam, yeah, but no seam. It is very expensive. Coming with a price tag around $2,000.
That's a lot for high school students, but if you can afford it, you should buy it. Well,
I can't afford it because I don't have a job. So.
Then you should get one.
Thank you for tuning in to Entertainment with me and my co-host here. And now we're going to pass it off to House Hoopla.
Hi, I'm Taylor Lang, and I'm here with one of our school captains at Bishop Hartley, Kimber Feelings. I'm going to ask her a few questions about House Hoopla. So the first question is, what events are planned for the upcoming House Day?
So we're excited for the March 13th House Day. We're doing something that's never been done before at Hartley, which is a game show House Day. So we've taken different game shows, like The Price is Right, Cake Wars, and American Ninja Warrior, and we've developed them into 10-minute games that we're going to be playing in the gym.
Got me in my feelings. Gotta be real with it.
Collaborate and listen. Ice is back with a brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly. Will it ever stop? Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights, huh? And I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a van.
Thank you, Trent and Taylor. Now let's send it over to Sharon and Ryan for Star Student.
Welcome to Star Student of the Week. I have Lanija Smith with me here. So Lanija, what teams are you involved in at Hartley?
I'm involved in the dance team.
How was the process of planning the Black History Month Assembly Dance?
It was low-key stressful because we wanted to, like, the captain had, like, a certain part we wanted to do, so we had to hire, like, a choreographer to create that dance. And then we had, like, a series of dances to create, and that took a while to, like, plan. And then, like, you know, the step team we had?
Yes.
That took a while to, like, have everybody, like, actually understand it and get it, and make sure everybody was on beat with everything. So it was a kind of a long process, but it all came together really well, so I'm really proud of that.
Who do you look up to, and who are your role models?
I look up to my mom and my grandma a lot because they're really strong and they really support me with everything that I do, and they are really just great people in my life. I'm very supportive of everything.
So back to the dance team. How was it being captain of the team?
I don't really like it. Sometimes it's like stressful because the girls don't like to listen sometimes, and like they like to do whatever they want to, but then you have to discipline them, and then they might have like attitudes that you might not want to like talk to you or whatever. So sometimes it's like hard, but sometimes it's like fun because you get to lead a team and like show how to be a leader to other people, and it's really, it's different to me.
Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Today we have Mr. Jahan here. So now, let's play Two Truths and One Lie.
Okay. So I'm going to tell you all three and you got to guess, right?
Okay, I'll guess.
Okay.
I'm going to have to say the third one was false and the first two were true.
That is incorrect.
What?
I've never completed the Thurman Challenge.
Are you riding? Say you never ever leave.
Thank you, Grace and Emmett.
You know, Lauren, I always wanted to play basketball, but I'm too short.
Now let's throw it to Jake and Hannah with athletic updates.
Hello, I'm Jacob Skurlock.
And I'm Hannah Sauer.
And we're here with athletic updates here at Bishop Hartley. First off, let's start off with girls basketball, who had a very successful season when they won their second CCL championship in a row. Unfortunately, they lost in the first round of the tournament, but they still had a successful season.
Boys basketball has had a very successful season, and they're on to the district championship this weekend.
The swim team under Coach Phillips had a very, very good year this year in 2019. Many swimmers and divers qualified for states. None won, but many placed, which is very, very good.
The cheerleading competition team qualified for regionals in early February and just recently went to states for the first time ever.
The bowling team, led by Mr. Blum, first year head coach, had a very good year, with many people placing in districts. The wrestling team, led by Mr. Petrella, had another very successful year and has four people competing in the state meet and many people who placed in the district.
Thanks for watching.
Now on to Cameron and Caroline with Club Corner.
Hi guys, it's Club Corner with Cam and Carol.
And we're about to go interview the Puzzle Club. Hi guys, I'm Cameron Castillo here with Stuart Landry. He's here to talk to us about the Puzzle Club. So Stuart, what do you guys do at the Puzzle Club?
So at the Puzzle Club, everybody brings in their puzzle or strategic board game, and pretty much what they do is that we come in and there's a riddle on the board, so everybody takes some time and solve that, and then we just converse about the puzzles or board games that we brought, and we just really have fun, and it's just really hanging out and having fun.
Seems like a lot of fun, Stuart.
Yeah.
So Stuart, how did the Puzzle Club get started?
So the Puzzle Club has it's been in my mind for about a year, and once I became a student at Bishop Hartley, I started the Puzzle Club really because, you know, there wasn't really a relaxed club. Everything was deadline this, deadline that. So I really wanted a place for people who were really stressed in a high school environment to really calm down and have fun with their friends.
Seems like a great time, Stuart. So, Stuart, how do you get involved in the Puzzle Club?
So, to get involved in the Puzzle Club, you just have to come to room 107 between 3 and 3:30. And then, after you come to the meet, then we'll add you to the email link in the group chat, and you'll be a full member of the Puzzle Club.
Seems like pretty easy to get involved. Thank you, Stuart, for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline and Cameron. Now let's send it over to Anthony and Chong for Major News.
Welcome to Hawks News, where we give you nothing but the facts. Today's top headlines, Venezuela's hyperinflation rate, and some angry saints. Let's get right to it. As of January 2019, Venezuela's inflation rate hit a record 2.69 million percent. This is thanks in part to the crash of oil prices in 2014, a crumbling socialist economy, expansion of the monetary supply, wage changes, and even the rise in America's economy. And now back to the States. Anger still lingers in New Orleans after the NFC Championship game. Saints fans were outraged after officials did not call a blatant pass interference on Rams cornerback Nickel Robey Coleman after he ran into Saints wide receiver Tommy Lee Lewis. Two season ticket holders have turned to sue the NFL for a range of charges, including mental anguish, emotional trauma, loss of enjoyment of life, and disgust of the game which has become the national pastime. A man named Matt Bowers has bought 10 billboards around Atlanta, one even outside the Falcons Stadium, where he showed his feelings with slogans like "NFL blew it" and "The Saints got robbed." And that's the way it is. This has been Anthony Metnis with Hawks News. Good luck and good night.
Thanks for that news report, Anthony and Sean. Now let's look into the main school story. Take it away, Megan and Caleb.
Thank you, hosts. I'm Caleb.
And I'm Megan.
And we're here to introduce the main school story. This week's main school story is Power School, the new system for next year.
We interviewed some faculty and a student, Ryan Hawk, to get some more info on the new system.
Good afternoon. We're here with Mr. Jahan to talk about the new ALMA we're getting next year. So what is the new system called?
The new system is called Power School.
All right, and then to follow up, what is Power School?
Power School is a student information system combined with a learning platform as well. So essentially what we're doing is we're combining some different programs we have. And what teachers and students will be using is called Unified Classroom. So that's where students will be accessing class pages, assignments, attendance, just kind of organizing all your information for you.
So why are we switching to Power School?
We just did some investigation over the past year and a lot this fall, but we've just kind of felt the room out, so to say, with our teachers and our staff, and it seemed that we need to make an improvement, and there was a product out there that was going to meet our needs. So this fall we spent a couple months talking with other schools, actually looking into the program, doing conference calls, and we chose this program because of the way it can adapt to us.
What other schools have this program?
Some of our CCL brethren, so to say, have them. Big D, Little E has it, St. Charles has it, and Watterson has it as well. So we actually have been talking to some of them a lot just to get their perspective, and they're helping us out quite a deal getting it started.
Okay, well, thank you for answering all of our questions.
All right, good afternoon. We're here with Mr. Egan to talk about the new system and his info on ALMA. So what are your opinions of ALMA?
It gets the job done.
Alright, have you heard anything about the new system we're switching to next year?
I have.
What is your take or input on that new system?
It seems as if it might be a more efficient way of doing things, and it'll make the entire process of dealing with a substitute teacher a little easier for regular teachers.
Alright, great. Well, thank you for your time.
Not anytime.
Good afternoon, I'm Megan Ballinger and I'm here with Ryan Hawk, and we're going to talk about ALMA and our new system for next year. So Ryan, what do you currently like and dislike about ALMA?
I like the simplicity of it. It's nice and like easy to navigate through, and then I don't like that I have an assignment for September that I never turned in and it's still there.
Okay, have you heard about our new system called Power School?
No,
but I heard it's better. Like, yeah.
What do you want Power School to have that Alma does not have?
I want to be able to see my like midterm and final exam grades, because we can't do that on Alma.
Okay. Thank you for answering my questions.
Thanks for watching this Bishop Hartley Network production.
See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.